On the contrary, they just say what their forefathers said before them, who said, what? After death, when our bodies are dust and bones, could we really be raised to life again? We have heard many such threats, and so did our forefathers before us. These are nothing but legends of primitive people. Say, to whom belongs the earth and everything therein? Tell me if you know. They will promptly reply, to Allah. Ask them, then why you don't use your common sense and believe in him? Say, who is the Rabb of the seven heavens and the Rabb of the glorious throne? Right away they will say, Allah. Ask them, then why you don't fear him? Say, in whose hands is the sovereignty of all things, protecting all, while against him there is no protection? Tell me if you know. Quickly they will reply, Allah. Ask them, then how you can be so bewitched? The fact of the matter is that we have brought them the truth, and undoubtedly these people are liars. Never has Allah begotten a son, nor is there any god besides him. Had it been so, each god would govern his own creation, and each would have tried to overpower the others. Exalted be Allah above the sort of things they attribute to him. He knows what is hidden and what is open. Far above is he from the shirk of these people. Pray, O my Rabb, if you inflict that punishment with which they are being threatened in my lifetime, then, O Rabb, do not include me among these unjust people. Surely we have the power to let you see the punishment with which they are being threatened. Repel evil with good. We are fully aware of their slanders. And say, O my Rabb, I seek refuge in you from the promptings of the shaitan. And O Rabb, I seek refuge in you even from their coming near me. These people will never refrain from wrongdoing until when death comes to any one of them, he will say, O Rabb, send me back so that I may do good deeds in the world that I have left behind. Never. This is just a statement which carries no value. It will be too late, because there will be a barrier between them and the world they have just left, till the day they are raised to life again. On the day when the trumpet will be blown, they will neither have worldly relations between them anymore, nor will they ask about each other. Then only those whose weight of good deeds is heavy will attain salvation. As for those whose weight of good deeds is light, they will be the ones who have lost their souls to live in hell forever. The fire will burn their faces, and they will grin therein with their lips displaced. We shall say to them, were my revelations not recited to you, and did you not deny them? They will say, O our Rabb, our misfortune overwhelmed us, and we became erring folk. Our Rabb, get us out of here. If we ever return to sin, then we shall indeed be wrongdoers. In answer to this, Allah will say, stay here in shame and do not plead with me. For you are the same people who used to make fun of some of my worshippers who prayed, Our Rabb, we believe in you. Please forgive us and have mercy on us, for you are the best of those who show mercy. But you ridiculed them so much that you even forgot my very existence and went on laughing at them. Today I have rewarded them for their fortitude, and they are the ones who have achieved bliss. They will be asked, how many years did you live on earth? They will reply, we lived there a day or a part of a day. You may ask those who kept the count. It will be said, well, now you know that your stay was just a little while. What a pity you did not believe it then. Did you think that we had created you without any purpose and that you would never return to us for accountability? Therefore, exalted be Allah, the real King. There is no God but Him, the Lord of the Honorable Throne. Whoever invokes another God besides Allah, about whose divinity he has no proof, he will have to give an account to his Rabb. Surely such unbelievers will never attain salvation. Say, O Rabb, forgive, have mercy. You are the best of those who show mercy. Surat An-Nur, in the name of Allah, the Compassionate, the Merciful. This is a surah which we have revealed and made obligatory. Its revelations contain clear verses so that you may take heed. As for the fornicatoress and the fornicator, flog each female and the male guilty of rape 100 lashes, and do not take pity in enforcing the law ordained by Allah, if you believe in Allah and the last day. And let a party of the believers witness their punishment. The fornicator shall not marry any but a fornicatoress or a mushrik, and likewise for the fornicatoress. None shall marry her but a fornicator or a mushrik. Such marriages are forbidden to the believers. Those who accuse a chaste woman of fornication and do not produce 4 witnesses to support their allegation shall be flogged with 80 lashes, and their testimony shall not be accepted ever after, for they are the ones who are wicked transgressors, except those who repent thereafter and mend their conduct, for Allah is surely forgiving, merciful. Those men who accuse their own wives but have no witnesses except themselves, each one of them shall be made to swear 4 times by Allah that his charge is true, and the 5th time calling down upon himself the curse of Allah if he is lying. As for the wife, the punishment shall be averted from her if she swears 4 times by Allah that his charge is false, and the 5th time calls down the wrath of Allah on herself if his charge is true. If it were not for Allah's grace and mercy upon you, you would have no method of handling these situations. Allah is the acceptor of repentance, all wise. Those who concocted the slander are from a clique among you. Do not regard this incident as only an evil, for it contains a good lesson for you. Whoever took any part in this sin has earned his share accordingly, and the one who took on himself the leading part shall have a terrible punishment. Why did not the believing men and believing women, when they heard this slander, think well of their own people and say, "This is clearly a false accusation"? Why did they not produce 4 witnesses? If they cannot produce the required witnesses, they are the liars in the sight of Allah. Were it not for the grace and mercy of Allah towards you, in this world and the hereafter, you would have been severely punished for your involvement in this scandal. When you passed with your tongues and uttered with your mouths that about which you had no knowledge, you took it lightly, while it was a very serious offense in the sight of Allah. Why did you not, when you heard about it, say, "It is not befitting for us to talk about it. God forbid, this is a monstrous slander"? Allah admonishes you never to repeat a mistake like this if you are true believers. Allah has made his revelations clear to you. Allah is all-knowing, all-wise. Those who love to broadcast such slanders among the believers will have a painful punishment in this life and in the hereafter. Allah knows and you do not know. Were it not for the grace and mercy of Allah towards you, this scandal would have produced very bad results for you. Allah is indeed very kind, most merciful. O believers, do not follow the footsteps of Shaitan, because anyone who follows the footsteps of Shaitan is seduced by him to commit acts of indecency and wickedness. If there had not been the grace and mercy of Allah upon you, none of you would have ever been purified from that sin. For it is Allah alone who purifies whom he pleases, and Allah is all-hearing, all-knowing. Let not those among you who are endowed with grace and aptitude of means swear to withhold their help from their relatives, the indigent, and those who left their homes for the cause of Allah. Rather, let them forgive and overlook. Do you not wish that Allah should forgive you? Allah